Hello everyone, welcome to today's stream. Today we are making some set designs for Cloud of Mentalities. Oh, I need to untangle all this, hold on. We're getting started with the set design for story 3, TeeBee Climbs a Tree and Meets a New Friend. And I talked with my boss at Clouded a little bit about this. And it turns out that the specific river this is meant to be based on is the Eno River in Durham, North Carolina. So I'm going to pull out some references for that. And I'm going to make this big. But I'm also going to pull up a reference. And I'll just keep that up. That's fine. Out a piece of our handy dandy watercolor paper. And we're going to have to trace this sketch onto this paper. Thinking of doing, since I gotta get all this done real quick, is sort of a speed run type thing. Or as much as you can speed run art. Let me get rid of my peg bar here. I'll do animation later today, but not right now. Water. So what I'm thinking of doing is sketching through all three of the background designs, because we've got TeeBee Climbs a Tree and Makes a New Friend, which is one illustration. And then story 4, TeeBee Falls in a Hole, will have two illustrations, because it's a big important story with a big tonal shift in it. Thank you.
Okay.
Not quite that high. That's looking solid, Vidri-ish. Thank you. making some leaf bundles here. I'm stumbling on some leaves. It's based on this specific river, but I'm making up my own spot in it. Because if I were basing it off of a specific part of it without a reference image, I would go insane. So... making my life easier. And I'm going to take a picture of this, send it to the group chat, and get started on sketch number 2. Story 4 actually has a slightly different influence. So, couple of influences for story 4. Story 4 takes place in this sort of magical underworld, like a magical other world that is below the earth that TeeBee's Adventures takes place on. With like, it's like fantastical and beautiful. I'm pulling up all the references I can for it. Okay, so this magical other underworld, with ginormous trees. It's dark, but with bioluminescence, with like these humongous trees, and like big open spaces, and like glowing mushrooms and cave creatures and all this, like, it's like this, it's kind of meant to be similar to Alice in Wonderland, but more foresty. Or at least that's how my boss described it. So this is my thumbnail for illustration 2, and this is my coworker's thumbnail for illustration 1. So, we've got the sketch for story 3. Oops. Wrong thing. I'm on F11, not F12. Okay.
Thank you. So they're less likely to be flat topped and more likely to be long topped. Make sense? light source, wouldn't it? Anything around it is. Within caves. That's what I'm starting to think. Like it's a layered space. Gonna take a picture of that and send that to the group chat now. Onto inking this one, I think. Thank you. You know, I feel like the last one should be a two-page spread. So let's... So the story's, the book's gonna be like these pages, right? Sketch it on these pieces of paper because I feel like it. Thank you. You know what? I think I'm gonna start inking this. Handy-dandy scrap page. think this is one of the best trees I've made yet. you know, I might take a break. See you guys soon. Bye.